But now as we've got everything connected, we have to purge the lines of air, non-condensables. You don't want to add non-condensables because it always slows things down. But you also have to make sure that you're purging in a way that is compliant with EPA de minimis rules. What that means is that you are purging carefully, just enough to remove air from the lines. In this case, we've hooked up a traditional recovery method, which is connecting from both sides, through a manifold, and through a hose, through a filter dryer, and into the recovery machine. One key thing to pay attention to with the filter dryer is that the flow is going in the direction that is marked with an arrow on the dryer itself. To do this with maximum control, we're going to use a manifold that has an additional port to the same connection. This allows us to purge just the side of the hose one side at a time before purging through the recovery machine. So purging one line at a time each to the manifold and then using one of those channels to purge the line through the recovery machine makes sure that you always have one direction of flow in that purge. So in this case, we're going to be purging the high liquid side, and I have a port here that I can keep cracked open and I'll be shutting as soon as I see refrigerant, see, smell, or see any sign of refrigerant reaching this line. Make sure that the valve is fully closed, and now, being prepared to fully shut, I will crack the valve there. And making sure that I close at the moment that I have any belief that I have refrigerant fully reaching that point. It's a 6-foot hose, and with a 3/8, there's a little volume, so it can take a little bit longer than just a brief second. But you do want to make sure that you are wearing good hand protection just in case it takes you that extra second to close the port. Now we have refrigerant purged all the way up to the manifold. I'm going to need to open one of those lines and get it purged through the recovery machine. Here's one advantage of using our valve core removal tools. They have a side port that we can actually keep open and have close very quickly as soon as that sign of refrigerant reaches that port. Now I'm going through 2 6-foot lines, and this could take more than just a brief moment. We've now purged refrigerant all the way through to the recovery machine. The final purge is the hose to the recovery cylinder. Again, you can use the same tip of the ball valve with a side port, using that as your low loss fitting on the hose. It has the added advantage of being a full flow valve, no restrictive valves like the auto shut off or quick disconnect valves. And that means you have full unrestricted flow. And plus, you can use that side port to make the purge very quick and very easy. Purging air from the lines in a de minimis compliant way helps prevent contamination of your recovered refrigerant, which is important if you intend to recycle your refrigerant back into the system after performing service work. Before you perform recovery, be sure to watch our other videos on choosing the equipment and connecting for full flow. Next up, full speed refrigerant recovery.